नमस्ते, माय नेम इज़ पृथ्वीराज संतोष जादव एंड आई एम अ फर्स्ट ईयर स्टूडेंट ऑफ भारती विद्यापीठ कॉलेज ऑफ होटल एंड टूरिज्म मैनेजमेंट स्टडीज़ एंड टुडे आई एम हियर टू स्पाइस अप सम मिनट्स ऑफ योर लाइफ एज वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट स्पाइसेस स्पाइसेस विच वेन एडेड इन अ टाइनी अमाउंट कैन ड्रामेटिकली अल्टर अ डिश बाय एडिंग डिस्टिंक्टिव फ्लेवर टू अदरवाइज ब्लैड इंग्रीडियंट्स. नाउ बिफोर मूविंग टू अवर मेन स्पाइसेस लेट्स टॉक अबाउट वॉट आर स्पाइसेस. Spices are aromatic flavorings from seeds, fruit, barks, rhizomes, and other plant parts used into season and preserve food. And as medicines, dyes, and perfumes, spices have been highly valued as a trade good for thousands of years. The word spice comes from the Latin spices, which means merchandise or wares. They are sold in dried form, but that doesn't mean spices last indefinitely. Their strong flavor will dissipate over time, especially if exposed to light and air. Now, let's have a look at what's the difference between cooking with whole versus ground spices. Cooking professionals almost always recommend buying whole spices and grinding them yourself, since whole spices retain their aromatic compound much better than the ground kind. But the reality is that most of us rely on ground spices for convenience. Having a mix of whole and ground spices in limited quantities that you will use up quickly will prevent a bunch of unused spices from languishing in your cabinet, losing flavor. Use whole spices for maximum flavor anytime you are able to grind your own or when adding them either directly or in a sachet to braises, stews, creams, teas, and other infusions. You can mellow the flavor of whole spices like mustard or cumin seeds by toasting them in a pan until they pop. Use ground spices in application where you want to disperse a lot of flavor, such as in a baked goods and spice rubs. Try frying a mix of different ground spices in oil or ghee to blend the flavors. Now, before you get to know about spices, let's take a note on how to store your spices. Store spices you use often in opaque glass jar or tin in a dark cupboard. Spices which you don't use frequently can be stored in airtight containers in the freezer. Remember to bring frozen spices to room temperature before opening to prevent condensation. Label spices with their purchase dates and give them a sniff every few months to make sure they are still pungent. Ground spices tend to oxidize more quickly than the whole spices due to their large exposed surface area and will lose their flavor within a few months, while whole spices can last up to a year. Since we use them in such small amounts, spices should be packed with flavors. Now, let's talk about 27 spices which are commonly used in Indian and international cuisine. And the first spice is allspice. Allspice, which is also called as kabab chini in Hindi and gol mirchi in Marathi, is a brown dried berry of the tropical Pimenta dioica tree, a clove relative native to West Indies and Central America that lends its distinctive flavor to Jamaican jerk seasoning and Swedish meatballs. Allspice got its name in the 17th century when Europeans decided it tastes like a combination of cinnamon, nutmeg, and clove with which it shares its primary aromatic compound, eugenol. Now, let's move on to our second spice, which is called anise. Anise seeds are actually the small ovoid fruit of Pimpinella anisum, a flowering plant in the parsley family. Anise has a very high concentration of lycoricey anethol, which is 13 times sweeter than table sugar. It is used to flavor drinks such as pasties and ozo, as well as Greek meat dishes. Candy-coated anise is eaten in India and the Netherlands, where it is also used to flavor milk. Now, let's talk about our third spice, which is caraway. Caraway is also called as Shahi Jeera in Hindi. The dried fruit of Caravum caravi, another member of the parsley family, caraway was one of the first spices cultivated in Europe, where it is still used to flavor sauerkraut, pork, and potato dishes. Its warm, anisey flavor comes from anethol, caravon, and limonene. Now, let's move to our fourth spice, which is called cardamom. Cardamom, which is called as ilaichi in Hindi, comes from the dry fruit of Eleutheria cardamom, a member of the ginger family indigenous to Southwest India. Its warm, sweet, floral, and fruity flavor is essential to Nordic baked goods and Arabic coffee. There are two main varieties of cardamom. Mysore, which is larger and green in color with woody and eucalyptus notes, and Malabar, which is smaller with floral notes and often bleached. Large cardamom, aka black cardamom, comes from a totally different plant, Amomum subellatum, which grows in the eastern Himalayas. It consists of long reddish pod with strong flavors from cineole and camphor that are often further enhanced by smoking. It is found in savory dishes such as pho. You can try cardamom in Chef Gordon Ramsay's roasted Turkish spiced eggplant recipe. Now let's move on to our fifth spice, which is called celery seeds. Celery, which is called as Ajmoda in Hindi and Owa in Marathi, is the teeny tiny fruit of the same plant that gives us celery stalks. Unsurprisingly, it has a strong celery flavor. It's used as a flavor in ancient Mediterranean cuisine and as a medicine in ancient China. Try celery seeds in pickles, sausages, and soups, or in a blend with salt to make celery finishing salt. Now, let's move on to our sixth spice, which is called chilies. Chilies, which are called mirch in Hindi and mirchi in Marathi, are fruits whose seeds are protected by the pungent burning chemical capsaicin. They are the most popular spice worldwide, with a consumption rate of 20 times greater than that of the second most popular spice, black pepper. There are 25 spices of capsicum, of only which 5 have been domesticated. Most of the chilies we eat come from capsicum annuum, first cultivated in Mexico 5,000 years ago. Chilies are often eaten fresh, but drying them for the spice cabinet will concentrate their flavor. Dried whole chili chipotle and anko chilies are used in Mexican cuisine to flavor soups and stews. Crushed into flakes, dried whole chilies become Korean gochugaru, essential to kimchi. Aleppo pepper adds heat to the Middle Eastern cuisine. In Hungary and Spain, chilies are ground into fine paprika pepper, which can be sweet or hot or smoked. Paprika makes an appearance in Chef Thomas Keller's fried chicken recipe. Now, let's move on to our seventh spice, which is called cinnamon. Cinnamon, which is called as dalchini in Hindi, is a spice that comes from the inner bark or phloem layer of the tropical cinnamonium tree, sold as rolled quills, sticks, or ground into fine powder. Cinnamon contains several aromatic compounds, the most recognizable of which is cinnamaldehyde, which gives cinnamon its spicy bite. Several different spices of cinnamonium are sold for culinary use. Cinnamonium cassia, the most popular variety in East Asia and the US, has dark, thick, coarse quills in a double spiral shape and a bittersweet, burning, spicy flavor due to high levels of cinnamaldehyde. This is the type of cinnamon used in Chinese five spice powder. Cinnamon goes particularly well with sugar. It is also used a lot in meaty savory dishes such as marakon tangais. You can try cinnamon in the Chef Gordon Ramsay's perfect rack of lamb recipe. Now, let's move on to our eighth spice, which is called clove. Clove is called lavang in Hindi. It is an immature dried flower buds of the Syngenium aromatium tree, native to Indonesia and used in Chinese cuisine for thousands of years and in Europe since the Middle Ages. Their 14-20% essential oil content means that cloves has the highest concentration of aroma compound of any spice. Their distinct flavor comes from the antimicrobial eugenol, which has made clove a popular medicine. These dried flower buds with their medicinal flavor are essential in dishes as diverse as roasted ham, Chinese five spice, apple crumble, and mulled wine. Go easy with them as they can easily overpower. Now, let's move on to our next spice, which is called coriander. Coriander is called dhania in Hindi and kothimbir in Marathi. Coriander seeds come from the small fruits that appear after the cilantro herb flowers. They can be harvested when green or they can be left to brown and dry out on the plant. Pounded fresh, green coriander has a bright flavor that's ideal for dressing a salad. A dried tanned pod is mostly often found in spice cabinet, has a citrusy floral taste that is often paired with cumin in Indian cuisine, Moroccan tangies, homemade burgers, or poaching liquor for fish. You can try it with Chef Gordon Ramsay's crispy duck with endive salad. Now, let's move on to our 10th spice, which is called cumin. Cumin is called jeera in Hindi and Marathi. Cumin comes from the small, rigid dried fruit of Cuminum cyminum, native to Southwest Asia. Cumin seeds look similar to caraway seeds and also taste somewhat alike. Cumin's main flavor compound is cumaldehyde, also found in eucalyptus. Chef Alice Waters liked to toast cumin to make cumin finishing salt. Try cumin spiced yogurt or use cumin as a rub for skirt steak to make carne asada tacos. Now let's move on to our 11th spice, which is called dill seeds. Dill seeds is the dried oval fruit of the same plant that produces the fresh herb of the same name. In India, we know it as shepu. It's native to the Mediterranean and Southeastern Europe and used there to flavor gravlax, bruschett and pickles. Its main flavor compound is carvon, also found in caraway and spearmint. Now let's move on to our 12th spice, which is called dried herbs. Spices are generally thought of as a bark, fruit or seed parts, while herbs are usually considered fresh plant leaves. But there are a few dried leaves that deserve a place in the spice cupboard, including rosemary, curry leaves, thyme, kaffir lime leaves and oregano. Keep in mind that dried herbs typically taste different from the fresh varieties and can't be substituted one to one. One of the most common dried herbs is bay leaf, which is called tejpatta in Hindi, which comes from the laurel family and is most often used to flavor soups, stews, braises and marinades. Safras leaves are also from the laurel family. They are dried and then grounded into powder to make file, used in gumbo and often serol dishes. Now let's move on to our 13th spice, which is called fennel. Fennel seeds, which are called badishop in Hindi, are the small dried fruits of the fennel plant, which is also eaten as a vegetable and herb. Fennel has a strong anise flavor as well as bitter, floral, fresh and pine notes. Native to Southwest Asia and the Mediterranean, fennel grows like a weed in parts of the US. It pairs well with pork and is an essential component of Italian sausage and Ethiopian barbare seasoning. You can try it in Chef Thomas Keller's braised artichokes dish. Now let's move on to our 14th spice, which is called fenugreek seeds. Fenugreek, which is called methi, is a flat yellow-brown seed from a Mediterranean plant in the pea family. It has bittersweet burnt sugar and celery flavors and is used to make chutneys and in the Moroccan spice blend ras el hanout. The seeds can be toasted to reduce their bitterness. Now let's move on to our 15th spice, which is called ginger. Ginger, which is called adrak in Hindi and ala in Marathi, comes from the rhizome of Zingiber officinale, a tropical flowering plant from the same family as cardamom and turmeric. The sharp bite of fresh ginger comes from the gingerol, an aromatic compound that partially transforms into the sweeter gingeron when heated or dried, which is why the ground ginger we use in pumpkin pie, gingerbread and ginger snap is so much less pungent than the fresh stuff. You can try it in Chef Gordon Ramsay's crispy whole branzino. Now let's move on to our 16th spice, which is called grain of paradise. The grain of paradise, which is called Nandanvan Dhanya in Marathi and Swarg Ke Anaj in Hindi, are the glossy brown seeds of Aframomium melaguta, a ready plant from the ginger family native to West African and Gulf of Guinea. Woody, floral and slightly spicy grains of paradise are used as a substitute for black pepper and as a pickling spice. Now let's move on to our 17th spice, which is called juniper berries. Juniper berries, which are called Hapunsa Jamun in Hindi and Karwanda in Marathi, are actually the small round seed cones of the juniper tree. The immature green berries are used to flavor gin, while the mature dark blue ones are crushed into pickling and to make marinades for meat, especially to reduce the gamy flavor of venison and wild boar. Juniper berries are bittersweet with notes of pine, wood and pepper. Juniper berries are also sold whole since their flavor compounds are very volatile. Now let's move on to our 18th spice, which is called mace. Mace, which is called Javetri in Hindi, is a plum-like fruit of Myristica fragrans, an evergreen tree native to Indonesia Ripin. They split to reveal a shell-covered seed surrounded by a fleshy red outer lattice called an aril. The aril is removed and dried to produce mace, while the seed inside the shell becomes nutmeg. Although they are often used together to spice mixtures for baked goods and browned meats, mace has a sweeter, more refined flavor than nutmeg, which comes from sabinine, pinene, myristicine and methyl eugenol. Now let's move on to our 19th spice, which is called mustard seeds. Mustard seeds are called sarso ke beej in Hindi. There are three main types of culinary mustard seeds: Mediterranean yellow or white mustard, which was the first and the only pungent spice available to early Europeans, now popular in the US. Himalayan brown mustard, which has become the dominant mustard in Europe due to its medium pungency and easy in harvesting. And black mustard, the most pungent variety. The burning sensation found in all three types of mustard comes from reactive sulfur compounds called as theocyanates, which are also found in onions, horseradish and wasabi, released when plant cell walls are damaged. Theocyanates are so tiny that they can escape food and enter nasal passages, which is why very hot mustard can make your nose burn. Cooking mustard seeds significantly lessen this effect. Now let's move on to our 20th spice, which is called Nigella. Nigella is called Kalonji in Hindi and Kayatil in Marathi. Nigella, aka black cumin, is a small black seed found in Southwest Asia, Africa and the Mediterranean. It has a fennel-like scent and mild complex flavor reminiscent of caraway, oregano and nutmeg. Nigella seeds are sprinkled on naan and kneaded into
Armenian
string cheese. Now let's move on to our 21st spice, which is called nutmeg. Nutmeg is called
Jaifal.
Tree in India is a plum-like fruit of Myristica fragrans, an evergreen tree native to Indonesia, Ripin. They split to reveal a shell-covered seed surrounded by a fleshy red outer lattice called an aril. The aril is removed and dried to produce mace, while the seed inside the shell becomes nutmeg. Nutmeg contains the same aromatic compounds as mace, sabinine, pinene, myristicin, and methyl eugenol, plus lemonine, geraniol, cineol, and safferol. Nutmeg is used in bechamel sauces, and both nutmeg and mace feature in eggnog and other spicy sweets. Now, let's move on to our 22nd spice, which is called peppercorns. Unlike with most other spices, there is no real reason to buy pre-grounded black pepper since pepper mills are readily available and easy to use. Wolfgang Puck likes to lightly toast peppercorns in the oven before grinding, an easy way to up the flavor even more. Black, green and white pepper all come from the fruits of the black pepper vine, Piper nigrum. The black kind has the strongest flavor. Immature green peppercorns available dried and brined are milder than the black and used in the Asian cuisine. And white peppercorns are just black peppercorns with their outer husk removed, mostly used for aesthetic purpose such as in white sauces. You will find all three kinds of pepper nigrum in Wolfgang Puck's pepper streak with red wine sauce. Whole peppercorns are ideal in braises like Thomas Keller's red wine braised short ribs. Sichuan peppercorns comes from a different plant entirely, a type of prickly ash of the genus Xanthoxylum. They lend their lemony flavor and numbing sensation to the Sichuan cuisine and are typically toasted to gain woody notes. Japanese sancho comes from Xanthoxylum as well, but tastes more citrus since it's not usually toasted. Pink peppercorns comes from the Brazilian pepper tree, first marketed as the type of peppers in the 1980s. They have a fresh, fine, citrusy sweet flavor and are often used in desserts. Now let's move on to our 23rd spice, which is called saffron. Saffron is called kesar in Hindi. Saffron is the golden stigma from the autumn crocus flower, likely domesticated in Greece during the Bronze Age. It's the most expensive spice in the world since the flower stigmas must be painstakingly hand harvested in a process that takes about 200 hours of labor per pound of dried saffron. Saffron adds its bitter, penetrating, hay-like aroma and golden color to bouillabaisse and paella. Now let's move to our 24th spice, which is called star anise. Star anise is called chakri phool in India. Star anise is the reddish-brown, star-shaped dry fruit of the Lycium verum tree, native to southeastern China and Vietnam. It's not related to anise, but they share the aromatic compound anethol. Star anise adds its sweet flavor to Chinese five spice powder and Vietnamese pho. You can try it in Chef Thomas Keller's pork shoulder a la Matignon. Now let's move on to our 25th spice, which is called sumac. Sumac is a dark red spice that comes from the fruit of shrubs from the Rheus genus, which is related to cashew and mango plants. It's popular in Middle Eastern and North African cooking, where it's sprinkled on the top of hummus and used to flavor meat. Sumac has a tangy, citrusy flavor due to malic and other acids, as well as woody pine notes. Now, let's talk about our second last spice, which is called turmeric. टर्मरिक इज कॉल्ड एज हल्दी इन हिंदी एंड हळद इन मराठी. टर्मरिक कम्स फ्रॉम द राइजोम्स अंडरग्राउंड स्टेम्स ऑफ क्यूर्कुमा लोंगा, अ जिंजर रिलेटिव फर्स्ट डोमेस्टिकेटेड इन प्री हिस्टोरिक इंडिया. इट्स ब्राइट ऑरेंज येल्लो कलर मेड इट एन इम्पॉर्टेंट डाय एंड इट्स शार्प अर्थली फ्लेवर इज रेमिनिसेंट ऑफ पेपर एंड मस्टर्ड, लैंडिंग इट वेल विथ मोरक्कन टैंगीज एंड इंडियन दाल. नाउ फाइनली लेट्स मूव ऑन टू आवर लास्ट द 27th स्पाइस विच इज कॉल्ड वेनिला. वॉट वी कॉल वेनिला बीन्स इज एक्चुअली द पॉड शेप फ्रूट दैट ग्रोज ऑन अ क्लाइंबिंग ऑर्चिड ऑफ द जेन्युस वेनिला विच इंक्लूड्स अराउंड 100 स्पीशीज. द पॉड्स themselves are 6 to 12 inch long and contains thousands of tiny seeds that stick to the pod walls. Vanilla flavor comes from the vanillin and around 200 other aromatic compounds found in both the sticky resin surrounding the seeds and in the pod wall. Freshly harvested vanilla beans have no scent. They must be damaged to release their aromas, a process which takes anywhere from a few weeks to several months. Once cured, vanilla beans can be processed into vanilla extract, which is made by running alcohol through the chopped up vanilla beans and then aging the mixture. Vanilla extract should be added towards the end of cooking since the prolonged heat will cause the flavor disappear. Vanilla bean seeds are a popular addition to cream brulee and cake frostings. You can try it in Chef Thomas Keller's cream anglaise. So now I take your leave. Stay home, stay safe. Bye-bye.